Do your thing. Cool.
What is this place?
This is not Klingon technology, Captain.
Oh no?
Even I can see that, you pointy-eared freak.
Oh my god.
Gentlemen, I suggest we start trying to find out what this is. I have a feeling we've come someplace Flick wasn't expecting us to go.
McCoy is freaking rabid right now. What the hell? Yeah, I didn't think this looked Klingon myself.
You look but see nothing of note.
Nothing of note?
A strange yellow light.
That it is.
This large gem appears to be an emerald of unusual size. This is obviously artificial.
Oh no, not an emerald of unusual size.
This large gem appears to be a sapphire of unusual size. This large gem appears to be a ruby of unusual size. This is up.
And I guess the others?
This large gem appears.
Right, and then there's these.
You look but see nothing of note.
These are not of note?
You look but see nothing of.
Okay.
You look but see nothing of note. Openings on the platform. Place something in these holes.
She says seductively.
Openings on the
okay. Analyze stuff, because we don't know what this is.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Oh, God.
Nothing to report.
The tricorder's recording functions are working, but it does not seem to be able to analyze.
Fascinating.
The tricorder's recording. Your tricorder's recording. Your tricorder's recording.
Okay. Let's look at everybody.
Your ever emotional. Your ever nervous crewman, Ensign Benny.
Ever nervous crewman.
James T. Kirk. Your ever
logical. Now we're ever nervous, logical, and emotional. And heroic.
We've got to get out of here, Jim.
I guess I should have taken a few more science courses at the academy.
I don't think that would have helped in this situation.
Obviously, they want us to place the gems in the holes, but which one?
Which
one? Captain, that the machinery is activated by placing the gems in the proper slots. We should determine a system for this.
Righto. So I guess we can't really go off the screen. Oh my god, he disappeared. I just want to make sure we can't actually go somewhere else. When the answer might be in another room. Nope, doesn't appear so. Well. There's gems here. Let's go red, green, yellow. What if I press these? Can I press these? Alright, grab that.
This large gem appears to be.
Okay. Red. Green. And then blue. I can't imagine it'd be that easy, though. And what do I do with that? Can we walk through that? Can we walk in there? Kind of forgot about that for a sec.
There is nothing at the moment.
Yeah. Damn it. Damn it.
That combination is restricted to higher order functions. Neural interlink required.
I beg your pardon? Alright, what about this thing?
Not prime for neural interlink. Not prime for neural inter. Not prime for neural.
Can I speak to this thing? Wait.
You get no response. You get no response.
Spock?
I suspect, Captain, that the machine.
Well, what are we. What's the neural interlink thing?
We've got to get out of here, Jim!
No kidding! Well, the one in the middle apparently activates this ray. So if I just switch these two, we'll get a red ray. And what will that do? Guessing, of course. Okay, here's the red.
Breach of protocol. Alien invasion imminent.
Oh no.
Internal security activated.
That doesn't sound good. Can I get these out? I wanted to leave the red one there, actually. Well, we're getting them all. Blue for safe. Safety.
That destination no longer exists. Transport abandoned.
Transport abandoned, huh?
Not prime for neural interlink.
Well, I want to get primed here. Prime me up, baby. Spock?
Your tricorder's recording functions are working.
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain. Captain, it seems to be some sort of interface device, but I do not know how to activate it.
Hmm. Nor do I.
Your tricorder's recording.
Okay, what if I just switch these two? Really, just trial by error here. So I'm gonna put the green on the left. See what happens.
Force field blocks trans system transport. Transport aborted. Use defense systems to eliminate alien vessels.
What?
Not prime for neural interlink. Not prime for neural interlink.
Fine, fine. I have no idea what we're doing here. We'll go green. Activate the green machine. Because I don't know which ones... which configuration these are at before.
Nothing happens.
To use any light, the first crystal must correspond to the color of the light.
Right. Well, I don't know what the meaning of the light is.
Not prime for neural interlink.
I'm pretty sure we tried this way, but I'm going to do it anyway. With the blue on the right.
That combination is restricted to higher order functions. Neural interlink required.
How do I get a neural interlink? Okay, so there's one red we haven't tried. I wish these guys would help me out here.
Breach of protocol. Alien invasion imminent.
Okay, put the green on the right. And hope this leads to something.
Combination is restricted to higher order functions.
How do I get a neural interlink?
Nothing happens.
Yeah. What if I just get all these?
Nothing happens.
Wait.
Nothing of note.
Yeah, it's nothing of note anymore. I don't suppose I can put anything here?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
I have all this stuff.
Your phaser is not working.
Oops.
Your phaser is not... Your phaser is not working.
Guys, help me out here. Speaketh.
I suspect, Captain, that the machinery is activated by placing the gems in the proper slots. We should determine a system for this.
It's interesting, though, that there's different gems. Perhaps they are different, they just look the same. Of course, how can we tell them apart, then?
There's nothing there requiring a ship's... Jim, I have no idea what it is. Why don't you try asking Spock?
Your tricorder's recording functions are working.
I don't suppose that has anything to do with the shirts we're wearing.
To see the logic in that action, Captain. I fail to see...
Right, so he can't take things.
He looks at you. He looks at you with a...
Figure maybe it could be a team thing of some way.
I certainly see nothing.
I'm confused here.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
I can't put him back, huh?
Nothing happens.
That combination is restricted to higher order functions. Neural interlink required.
I am really confused. Trying to go off. What if I... How did we come in here again? Through the Klingon door, but where is the door?
You look but see nothing. You look but see nothing of note.
It's interesting that we can't look at these things. Can I press them? Can Spock press them?
Your tricorder's recording function. Your tricorder's recording.
Okay, what if we get red shirt to press the red one?
He looks at you.
Nobody needs heat. Nobody needs healing, Jim. But you will if they harm my patient.
Threatening.
Your tricorder's.
I'm kind of lost right now. Damn. Is this something?
You look but see nothing. You look but see nothing.
There's gotta be something else. Because really, I've tried all combinations. I take the red out. Put it back. Oh, right. Combinations of the same color.
That combination is restricted to higher order functions. Neural interlink required.
What if we make it just all red? I don't know why I didn't think of that before, guys. You guys are probably yelling at me. All red, baby. What happens?
Planetary defenses revived. All alien vessels in orbit destroyed.
Load a previously saved game.
I just destroyed the Enterprise. Oh, brother. Okay, all green. Can't get the other one. Just interrupts if he's not already putting it in.
This is Bialbi, High Mentalic of Rakur. For defense, use the light of war. For information, use my light.
Okay.
For transportation, use the light of travel.
I guess blue?
Sequences are keyed by combinations of crystals. Integrator now active.
Integrator now active.
A platform emitting a beam of light. A strange yellow light. You get no response.
Well, it's an interactor, so interact with us.
This is Bialbi, the most advanced life form on this world. Thank you for informing us of the situation. It shall be resolved.
Oh.
Admiral Blicht, this is the defensive system of Rakur. You have engaged in genocidal activities on this world.
I didn't
have
say that.
Have you anything to say before your sentence is passed?
Kirk! This is your doing!
No, Admiral, it is not. But that will suffice as a final public statement. The sentence is banishment to you and all members of your crew who are involved in this action.
You have no right to try me!
I have as much right as you to conduct trials on this planet. You showed no justice to your victim. The penalty for injustice is death.
Oh boy.
Kirk!
Hoist on your own petard, Evlicht. Do you want me to help you?
Well, what does the blue do?
You tried to send me to my death. Now you can rot as you get what you deserve.
Oh, a little bitter, huh?
If I have your word that Quetzalcoatl goes free, I'm willing to intervene to save you. Hoist on your... If I have your word that Quetzalcoatl goes free, I'm willing to intervene to save you.
Agreed.
A life for a life is a just bargain, but his crimes are beyond count.
I do not see what can be served by more killing.
Idealism, an advanced concept. Naive, perhaps, but charming in its simplicity.
Admiral
Blicht, the entity Quetzalcoatl shall be set free. If you ever return to this sector, the sentence shall be carried out. No Klingon vessel may ever return to this world.
Very well. I agree to your terms.
As for you, Captain, you may return. I find your social development most pleasing.
I fear that politics will make it impossible. Your planet is in Klingon space. But I don't understand why the Klingons never detected you.
Their archaeological digs did come close, Captain, but I am very elusive. I waited and monitored the situation and chose to reveal myself to you. Now you may go. Heed my warning, Blicht. I shall not be merciful a second time.
Interesting. Well, I want to see what the blue does.
Klingon ship leaving the area.
We will be setting course for Digifal. It's the closest thing to a home that Quetzalcoatl has.
It would appear everything worked out for the best.
Except for the people of Rakur, Mr. Spock. Except for the dead.
True that.
We have read your report on the problems at Rakur and evaluate your performance at 100%. You and your crew received 4 commendation points.
We're on a roll.
A perfect mission, Jim. You are a model for all Starfleet.
Oh, get out of here, you.
That old devil moon.
Message from Starfleet, sir.
On screen, Lieutenant.
The Enterprise will proceed to the Alpha Proxima system. While the indigenous race on Proxima 3 has not reached a technological level commensurate with entering the Federation, and therefore under the protection of the Prime Directive of non-interference, we do maintain a discrete monitoring satellite. It has picked up activity from an asteroid in an elliptical orbit. You are to investigate without interfering with life on the planet.
According to the library computer, the Alpha Proxima system has 5 planets and an asteroid belt. A large asteroid is heading towards the inner planets and should pass close by Proxima 3. It passes through the interior of the system once every 200 years. The people of Proxima 3 call it Scythe, the same name as their god of war.
God of war, Mr. Spock? Isn't that a bit surprising from a people whose technology matches 20th century Earth?
Considering the level of warfare during that century, I'm surprised that it is Earth that did not have a god of war. In any case, about a millennium ago, Proxima 3 suffered a globally devastating war.
Blew themselves back to the Stone Age, Mr. Spock?
Late Bronze Age, Ensign. They rebuilt their world in half the time it had taken to get there originally. But the Armageddon was mythologized as a battle between the Sofs and Lucas. In that war, the planet was razed, and all the gods died except Scythe. He had rained fury down upon the world, then went off on a long dance of victory. His return is a time for worldwide soul-searching and atonement.
And Scythe returns, and our monitoring station picks up activity.
It would seem that we should proceed to Alpha Proxima and scan Scythe.
So it would seem, but I want to see what that is, what that blue light is, so... Alright, blue light. I can never seem to get this middle one.
Transport you only in proximity of nearest humanoid life. Transport imminent.
Interesting. Hi.
How dare you! The test was supposed to take place without interference from your ship. You have shown all lack of honor.
Oops. Give me a break, Flicked. You were trying to kill us. I believe that the use of guile to do what the enemy does not expect is considered very honorable by the Klingons.
Touché, Kirk.
You didn't say I wasn't allowed to use my ship's computer. You didn't explain the rules clearly. Whose fault is that?
I believe
the use of guile to do...
How dare you lecture me on points of honor? I, the most decorated warrior in the entire Empire.
Oh, for sure.
I, who took the dishonored trash of my homeworld and destroyed it with a fist of steel.
Then you admit it was you and not Quetzalcoatl who was responsible for the death of Rakur.
Ooh.
Those who lose honor lose life, Kirk. Tis the Klingon way.
Then you will not object to presenting the orders from the Klingon Council, authorizing mass murder on Rakur.
The trial is over. He is guilty. Done. Carry out the sentence.
I won't let you.
No, Captain. Let there be an end to this violence. I will not allow any more blood to be shed, save my own. I taught the doctrine of self-sacrifice, and I shall die of it. But before I die, I believe that Klingon law allows me to make a public statement. Hmm. Intelligent beings are not meant to be caged either by tyranny or barbarism. Those who try doom themselves to failure.
That's right.
Once a culture has tasted peace, it will not desire anything else, because peace is better than war.
I'm not sure that would
Love
happen.
Love is better than hate, and creation is better than destruction. This is truth. I, who was once immortal, know that truth is the only true immortal. You can kill people, cultures, even gods, but the truth will always survive.
The death ceremony shall take place aboard the Cleata. I trust you are satisfied that justice has been done.
Did you listen to anything he said? One day, in spite of people like you, the Klingons will know peace. I hope I live to see that day.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you're a praying man, Blake. If I were you, I would not want to meet me again.
Haha.
Justice? Did you listen to anything he said?
This one?
Scotty, beam us up.
So in this, I guess we get a less than 100% score. Let's check it out.
Captain's log. We've returned to Federation space having tried and failed to save a new friend.
Sad ending.
Quetzalcoatl was a remarkable creature, Captain. It is a great loss.
He died for what he believed in.
Yet so did many men who were judged by history to be evil. Dictators, assassins. Self-sacrifice in itself is not a virtue.
Still, I cannot find it in my heart to condemn him. He had a great dream of peace, and it's been left to others to fulfill it. Let's get started. Ahead warp factor 2 to Alpha Proxima, Mr. Sulu.
Why are we going to Alpha Proxima?
We have read your report on the problems at Rakur and evaluate
That's
your
all.
Performance at 66%. You and your crew received 1 commendation points. A satisfactory performance, Captain, but there's still room for improvement.
Wah, wah.
That old devil moon.
Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. See you in the next episode. The other ending. I'm going to go back and restore and play the other ending and save. And that's going to be my canon ending for the Let's Play. That's what I originally chose, so I'm sticking with that one. That's the better ending. So we're on a roll. 100% twice in a row. So I just wanted to see what would happen with the blue. Kind of wondering if anything would happen with other combinations, actually. I might go back and mess with that. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.